It is a decision with sweeping implications for the future of juvenile justice, but the impact on decided cases remains unclear. New Hampshire has four murderers who committed their crimes as 17-year-old juveniles. Eduardo Lopez killed a Nashua man. Robert Dingman murdered his parents. Robert Tulloch convicted in the Zantop murders. And most recently, Stephen Spader was convicted in the Mont Vernon home invasion murder.
That case was tried and is currently still on appeal. So that's the case that seems to be most likely impacted by this decision.
Spader's attorneys say they're still reviewing the Supreme Court's ruling, but they do believe it applies to their client.
We may very well file a motion with the court to address the issue and discuss it with the judge, see what the state's position is, but we're not there yet.
Nobody's going to go free. Nobody's going to all of a sudden be freed from jail and be walking the streets.
UNH law professor Buzz Scherr says any motions would still be heard by the judge who handed down the original sentence, and that judge could decide to uphold the sentence or reduce it.
The judge has more discretion and will likely look at who that individual is in terms of what would be best both for society and that individual's rehabilitation.
But even if a sentence was reduced, he doesn't think a convicted murderer would get much relief.
I don't expect any of them are going to see the light of day for a long time, even after resentencing.
For future cases, the AG's office anticipates the state will still be able to sentence juvenile offenders to life without parole.
At least our initial reading of the Supreme Court's decision is that states could impose a life without parole sentence on juvenile offenders, but it couldn't be mandatory. But again, we're still in the process of reviewing the case.
Legal experts say the bottom line is that under this decision, judges will have to be more thoughtful about how they approach juvenile sentencing, but this ruling does not eliminate life sentences for juveniles. Reporting in the newsroom, Adam Sexton, WMUR News 9.